Hey everybody, welcome back to Northern Line Plays, The Binding of Isaac Rebirth. We are due for a run as Isaac. Seems a little framey. Our win streak's at minus one because I lost on the show. I lost on the super show. I actually won the seeded run that took place and lost as an Azazel run while waiting for Nick to finish a run. Here's our seed, by the way. TC7K. 1LZW. We had Monstro's Lung, Ipecac, Pyromaniac, like piercing shots, and I was waiting for Nick to finish his run, and I was like, oh, I don't want to ruin my streaks, but I'll play as Azazel just to get some time killed, and then just rushed and lost. It's my own fault, but still, man, how do you take, you know, 52 minutes on an Ipecac run? I'm not over it yet. The salt is still real. It's okay. This room is always weird, but sometimes you do get the benefit of having that happen. Although, is it really a benefit when there's nothing inside of it? Wow, Super Bandage is pretty sweet, though. Still pretty sweet, in spite of my idiocy. Of all of the HP upgrades, this is one of them. I'm gonna set a goal. I think I do better with firmly established goals. Our goal is... our streak, if it starts at negative one and we win, our streak goes to... one, right? Like, that's the only thing that makes sense. It wouldn't make sense if it went to zero. Anyway, our streak should be zero. I mean, I guess it's a rare streak, zero. That's your streak if you've lost one run, but not lost two in a row. Anyway, long story short. If you win, it doesn't matter. I'm getting up my own butt. Let's win with all 10 characters in a row. It's a start, right? We basically did that on our mammoth streak. Let's make it happen here. We got 10 characters to go. Starting with Isaac. I'm not really scared of Isaac. I think Isaac gives us our best chance, but things could go wrong, you know? You look at the schedule for who your football team's gonna play, and you go, oh, we're playing the, you know, who's bad? We're playing the Tampa Bay Buccaneers in week 8. That'll be a good one. But sometimes the Buccaneers will surprise you, man. No offense if you're from Tampa Bay. I mean, you don't play for the team, probably. If you do, that's pretty awesome, you know? Congratulations on achieving what's probably, like, a pretty ambitious childhood goal of yours. It's pretty amazing. So we do have a Spirit Heart still, thankfully, in spite of my ineptitude. We also picked up Cricket's Head right off the bat. This is another reason I'm not too worried about Isaac. If there's any characters I'm worried about, honestly, Azazel a little bit, just because I have a tendency to take some really dumb damage, but for the most part, it's okay. Maggie a little bit, Eve, Samson, and Lazarus kind of a lot. Blue Baby's in the middle category, but I at least like playing as Blue Baby, so all is forgiven. Early Cricket's Head is an extraordinary pickup. I'm not sure if it's... does Cricket's Head make it so every item you pick up for the rest of the game gives you 1.5 times its normal damage? Like, all damage modifiers are even better? Or does it make it so the ones that you had when you picked it up double it? Because it does make a difference. It'd be better to pick it up later if it was the latter. But I think it gives you 1.5 times damage for the rest of the game. Like, no matter what. We're one-shotting these spiders, which is good. The spiders are not the weakest enemy on the first floor. First series of floors. We found out that the dips, you know, the little poops, they actually have less HP than the spiders. We had a run earlier where we actually managed to test that. Not necessarily like that was the most important thing. Don't message me on Skype. I will fight you to death forever. All right, if you'll pardon me for a moment. I was on a roll there. I hate when someone sends me a nice message on Skype. They go like, hey, you know, I had a lot of fun on the stream today. And then I have to just... say nothing. Well, I don't have to say nothing, but it's kind of funnier that way. And just sign out. Like, I'm fucking busy. Don't bother me with your compliments when I'm busy, okay? I've got shit to do. Yeah, sure, it feels nice. Yeah, okay, thanks a lot. Don't ever compliment me ever again when I'm working. It goes against every bone in my Canadian body to say that. Every bone in my, this is gonna be like, what's the rudest nationality of people? I'm not gonna answer that question. That only leads to tears. The answer may surprise you, though. More keys, more spirit hearts. With two spirit hearts, it's a little risky and it's a stupid waste, but I'm gonna come down here and check out our curse room first. Maybe we can get a reroll there if we need to reroll something. Don't get hit by that bomb. Thank you. Pills? Balls of steel. Ah, all is forgiven now. So I'm not gonna take this other pill. Just in case it is like some kind of teleportation, I'd rather stay far away. I think I've played alright on this run. Dodges have been bad. Gotten great luck, though. We always talk about your ability to dodge. Nobody ever talks about your ability to actually, you know, hit the enemies. You know, that's something that people don't care about at all. Chemical Peel is fine as far as I'm concerned. No one ever goes, oh, you know, Northern Lion's dodging sucks, but his accuracy is off the chain. I think I've got pretty good accuracy in Isaac, you know? Above average at the very least, but all I ever hear is, oh, he sucks at dodging. Except for those lost runs, but, you know, those are, you know, anybody can pick the, you know, pick a number between 1 and 100. If you do it 100 times, you'll be right once, maybe. Possibly. Not, statistically guaranteed, but statistically, you got a chance. I'd be the greatest statistician. What do you think the odds of this happening are? You know, it could happen. If you did it enough, it could happen. Don't want to take the pill, just in case it's a teleportation. If it is a teleportation, I'd like to know so we can get another one and then make it the boss rush. And then teleport out of boss rush for free. Very easy fight against the haunt. Deal with the devil is all but guaranteed. We'll save that. Don't need to pick that up yet. Yeah, we'll reroll that one. Oh, it's been too long. I'm excited. And full health. Man, this is a crazy run thus far. You know, you can bitch about me getting Mom's Knife all you want, but we haven't had Mom's Knife in a long time, actually. We've had Brimstone a couple times recently. Sometimes for the best, sometimes not necessarily. Well, it's always better to have Brimstone than not have it. Hasn't always been a run winner for us, though. Except I think we've won every run that we've had it in. So disregard that. I don't know what the fudge I'm saying, only I didn't say fudge. Stay away from me. Now we need a deal with the devil for guppy items, and then I can just, what'll I complain about then? Oh, we don't have a lot of money. Oh my god. Give me some... Game, would it kill you to give me some flippin' money? I just want to buy things from your shops and engage in, you know, the process of capitalism with you, and you refuse to give me any... Oh my god. Secret room? Oh, yeah, I mean, sure, you give me a secret room, but it's not the same. It's not quite the same thing. We'll take these. Pretty fly. Lock up. Those are three decent pills. Makes up for the shop being kind of shitty. Not going to go fight the boss right away because I do want to have a reroll if it's at all possible. Our last reroll did gangbusters for us. I don't know. What does that even mean? I gotta know about busters, alright? I know a scrub is a guy who thinks he's fly, also known as a buster. That's what Lisa Left Eye Lopez told me. However... What is it? People are always talking about Dam Busters. You know, it's a mini game from Action 52. It's also a movie. What is a Dam Buster? It's got something to do with the Second World War. And then what's a Gang Buster? Are you actually busting up gangs? That is like the most 1920 slang I've ever heard in my entire life, next to like Beer Runner or Rum Runner. That's it. You know, Canada, a strong history of Prohibition era rum running. I'm not saying that you should necessarily be proud of it, but let's see, you know, being so close to the American border made a lot of sense, I guess, economically speaking. Now, that's crazy when you think back, you know? People are like, oh, that's a long time ago. It was in the 20s. That's less than 100 years ago. 100 years is a long time within the span of a human life, but man, you think about it. What do you think about the world in 1600? What do you think about the world in 1700? Doesn't feel that different, right? Our world has changed a drastic amount, maybe just because we're closer to it, but our world has changed a drastic amount. I know there's things, you know, like the Renaissance and, you know, Reformation and stuff like that that happened during those time periods. I'm just saying, I could have rerolled this. That when you're so close to it, those, like, seemingly not that long time scales, they make a big difference, man. I can't believe it. Less than 100 years ago, drinking alcohol was illegal in the United States of America. United States of America, where you have, you know, Bud Light ads on every football stadium, on every TV show. Things change. I know there are still places in the world where alcohol is illegal. I'm not saying the default position should be that alcohol is not illegal either. I'm just, you know, it's funny how things change. Even within my own lifespan, you know? I was one of the first... people in my first, well, we weren't really people back then, we were just children. One of the first people in my, second grade class to get a computer. It was like 1997. I got a computer. People were like, whoa, well, you got a fucking computer? It's not like they were super rare at that point, but it was like, man, that's crazy. Now I see like 5-year-olds with smartphones. I don't even trust myself with a smartphone. I hope this generation turns out smart, man. They got the tools. I believe in it. Takes a while, you know? People always judge a generation by, like, its youngest people. That was, oh, this upcoming generation, that's the problem with them. It's not that it's the generation is bad, it's just that the person you're talking about is 14 years old. You know, 14-year-olds are not the people that you should be judging a generation on. Judge a generation by what they've done, not what they're doing, you know? I'm not gonna reroll my whole run. I like this run. I'm a scumbag, but I earned Mom's Knife, as far as I'm concerned. People are always, oh, that's the problem with this generation. That's the problem with this generation. No, 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 you shouldn't do that. You should look back. You know, when you don't get your generation judged when you're 15, you should get your generation judged when you're 50. So we'll be taking a look at, like, the baby boomers right now and being like, okay, how's it going? I know that there's got, like, kind of a little bit of a, you know, worldwide economic recession, war on terror. Not totally sure. You know, you should be talking about these 14-year-olds. We got our own battles to fight on our own soil in terms of, you know, generational issues here. I'm not saying my generation is any better or worse. I'm just saying, you know, let those whose generation has never thrown stones live in a glass house. See, that's the most elegant way to phrase that, certainly. I like that. You shouldn't judge a generation by what they've done when they're 15. Judge them by what they've done when they're 50. Or 500 if Ray Kurzweil gets his way. Now, I'm still not going to reroll our whole run. It's been a slow kind of turn of events here, which has allowed me to get philosophical. But hey, Mom's Knife, it might as well be the talking stick, right? It just, you're already going to have a very good chance of winning the run. Why did I take Spelunker's hat? I like it. Is that a good enough answer for you? Jeez, give me the third degree. That's the problem with this generation these days. They always want to know things. We're going to go all the way to the far right, because I'm guessing that that is where our secret room has to be. Wow, all right. Maybe I just missed... I totally missed it on the map, but I'm not going back, all right? You can't make me go back there. A second secret room doesn't mean all that much to me. Although, if I take damage, red heart damage on the next floor, it might if we would have gotten a spirit heart or something out of it. But hey, we got a shop in here with a demon judgment. You got to hug the demon judgment, and then you get half-price deals here. Usually. Got to be careful. Luck up. I can't play you anymore. We'll come back, but I can't play you anymore right now. I shouldn't have played you that much, to be honest with you. Now, we do have one third of the Guppy Triumvirate. We got Guppy's Collar. That would be like the Cassius of the Triumvirate. So, we got a long way to go before we pick up like a Julius Caesar in the form of 9 lives or something like that. I would like some red hearts. I'm very, very concerned that I will walk on a spike in that room, so please allow me to pick up some red hearts. In fact, we're going to stand far, far away. Have a good opportunity to maybe get a full health pill in here. Pheromones. I actually like Liberty Cap, decently enough. Pop pheromones. I like that a lot. Still no red hearts, but there is a secret room here. I took Roman history in college. Now I'm like, who are the members of the Triumvirate? You got like, was it Crassus? It wasn't Cassius. It was Crassus. There's a full health here. Nice. It's so meaningless to have this discussion right now. It's like Julius Caesar, Mark Antony. No. Yes, Mark Antony. No, Mark Antony. Mark Antony. Common misconception. That's Jennifer Lopez's ex-husband. I think they got divorced anyway. Who gives a shit? It doesn't matter. It's not your life. Why do you care? We don't need anything here. Take our spirit heart. Where are we gonna go? I saw an out, but yeah, this is more along the lines of what I was looking for. We got a reroll ready. We could probably get a charge from our shop if we have to. I like doing that whenever possible. I can't believe I'm going this slowly with Mom's Knife. That's gonna slow us down a little bit further, in fact. Infamy. Infamy is okay. Part of the problem with this run right now is that we're just getting too many okay items. Not enough, you know, items that are really doing dam busters for us. Gang busters, whatever. I did lose my spirit heart, but I didn't take damage there. But I have taken red heart damage on this floor, so I really doubt we're going to get a deal with the devil. But if we get a deal with the devil after our boss fight, that's good. I think we'll probably end up doing a little backtracking either way. We did get a deal with the devil. We didn't deserve it. I'm okay with little Steven. That hurts. That's a painful one. I'm gonna check this out. What do you got for me? We do have a battery. If we had a spirit heart, I would like it, but what I'm gonna do is play the crap out of this demon judgment again. Hopefully I won't take damage on my way back through this room. I know there's a tinted rock in this room, but this room can also suck on my testicles. Yeah, there's no way we're getting to that Tinted Rock without the ability to fly anyway. I think we can still make Boss Rush, but beyond that, I'm not really that worried about Boss Rush because we're in a position where we're probably not going to get the Teleport card anyway. Balls of Steel. Oh, I love it. I love it a lot. This makes my life a lot easier when it comes to going into the Boss Rush room. Paralysis is not really a good pill at all. What about that one? Pretty Fly. It's lovely. I appreciate it. Paid out. Oh, it didn't pay out yet. Okay. I figured 1 cent couldn't hurt. Blow you up. Get another cent back. All right. I was looking more for the red hearts, which I appreciate. I was going to say, you got to pay out by now. We could honestly probably make do with a speed upgrade, but we're still doing fine on time here. Crystal Ball. Crystal Ball's pretty good. We'll re-roll it. We get Revenge Fly. That's also pretty good. Now, I was looking for a, I was looking for Guppy items more than anything else, but it's okay. I love that you get, like, a brief period of invincibility when that happens. Alright, that was a really good turn of events. Now we can turn around and take, the Spirit Heart that we got and take it to this Curse Room and hope for another Guppy item. Or more Spirit Hearts, which is also great as well. Okay, so we're going to move along now. We're going to be leaving at like 14 minutes. I'd say Boss Rush is a little bit of an unlikely plausibility, but it's unlikely. What am I even talking about? Oh, we've already been to our secret rooms. A bunch of people pointed out, by the way, that I actually am missing more items than I had originally thought. I'm missing SMB, or not SMB Superfan, but Super Meat Boy, which also unlocks Raw Liver, so I've never had Raw Liver. And I'm missing D100. So there's like three things that I'm missing, I guess. There might be one more. I might be missing Dead Dove, or I might be missing... Someone said I was missing the 1-Up, but I'm pretty sure I picked up the 1-Up. Picked it up all the time in vanilla, but that doesn't necessarily mean anything. I can't reroll Abel. He's like an old friend, and, you know, maybe he's become dead weight, but I still love his company. So that's the most important thing when it comes to friends, you know? Hey, sorry, you haven't really been pulling your weight in the friendship lately. I don't want to be that guy. Seriously though, Abel, if you could just like, if you could kill one enemy, at least that would give me something to show the friendship board and be like, look, he's trying. 15 minutes. Again, possible, but unlikely. Now, I would like to get over there. We need one more bomb to make it happen. The items in, oh, we have a teleportation card. It's on, baby. The items that show up in those stone chests have a real tendency to be heads. I'm not sure if you can get Goat Head in it, but you can definitely get like Guppy's Head, Tammy's Head. Guppy's Head in particular would be awesome because then we could pick it up and reroll it. As much as I love it, it's not integral to our survival to have Guppy's Head. I should not have just stood there probably. That's my honest assessment of how that went down. How do you feel about this? 15 minutes. I should have time to get to our item room, but I don't know. I might just fight the boss and then try to get to the item room on the next floor, all other things being equal. This is an expression I use a lot that I don't fully understand, I guess. That's not a good context to use that. We've gotten very, very lucky on this room. Thank you, Revenge Fly. Yeah, let's skip the item room on this floor, so that we can get to the item room on the next floor. Because we're already here. That's, I guess, what I mean by all other things being equal. If all other things are equal, we're already here. We might as well go. Emperor. That's actually worse as a teleport card for my purposes. Yaha. Yah. That's worse as a... I want to do it this way, actually, so that we actually lose more HP. I know that sounds messed up, but that went really well. The Hermit card is better as a teleportation card because if we use it after the boss rush room, we don't end up in the boss room, which means we can actually hit some more rooms, like maybe the item room in the shop, for example. Now, admittedly, my HP kind of sucks. Here's another admission for you. Doesn't really matter if your HP sucks when you have Mom's Knife. Even with base Mom's Knife damage, pretty decent chance that you can kill the late game bosses without getting hit as long as you have enough cracks at it. Guppy Dream is alive and well, and I love having rerolls ready for the boss rush room. If we could make that happen, I would be a very happy individual. The Quarta. I don't think this is a great item, but what I'm basically saying is I'll pick this up, and then when the shop shows up later, I'll get my money's worth, hopefully. You know, I'll pick up another charge that might give me another reroll. I'll buy an item if we're not fighting greed, which is, like, completely within the realm of possibility. Need to get some momentum on these shots. Keys might come in handy, because I am hoping to get Guppy's tail. Might not be super likely, but it could happen. I should have taken damage probably twice there, which could have killed me. Although, to be fair, after I had taken it the first time, maybe I would have adjusted my playstyle. You know, that's what humans do. They learn from their mistakes. That's what I'm hearing from my spaceship on the planet Epsilon. I'm trying to act a little bit more like them so that I may, you know, impregnate their women and propagate my species here on this moist planet, so unlike any others in the galaxy. A little bit more money there. That'll be useful to our effort here. I would just like you to explode, thank you. I really needed to make this guy get hurt before he gets over here. My hitboxes are all jacked up. Cartridge, not necessary. Boss room, this is perfect. Yeah, plenty of time. Probably, admittedly, could have afforded to look for the boss room. Or sorry, the item room on the last floor. No deal with the devil. So we'll take this. But we didn't, and here's where we are. Tiny Planet Mom's Knife is awful. Firemind is okay, but I'd rather reroll. Reroll gets Spoonbender, Virgo. Spoonbender's okay. I'll take it just in case we end up picking up like Brimstone or something. That could be funny. But all in all, it's a pretty not fantastic haul for us. So store credit is worthless, as is probably like most of this money we have. I'm actually very disappointed with the way that boss rush room worked out for us. Shit happens, though. Really? That's a surprise. I didn't know there were four of them on that room. And, you know, Spoonbender, it's an item of dubious help, but it does, you know, carries a little bit of a benefit associated with it most of the time. Sometimes you can end up, you know, accidentally not hitting enemies that you should be hitting, but most of the time it ends up working out pretty well for you. So we're going to be low on HP, but the main enemies that are, dangerous there are just enemies that are able to hit us from afar. Enemies that can't hit us from afar have nothing on us. No special rocks there. We do have an arcade. I don't really want to go to that arcade. I also don't want to work. I just want to bang on my drum all day. A very strange song. Can you imagine? Like, I want to see that dude's life in like 5 years. They're like, oh, dude, what do you do? Oh, you know, like, I'm a stockbroker at a Fortune 500 company. How about you? I'm banging my drum all day, dude. What is you just like, you're a drummer? No, I just bang all my drum all day. I don't want to work. Oh, cool. Why do you do it? Freedom, man. Just, I didn't want to be a slave to the man. Oh, that's cool. With the money I made in my job, I went skiing in Austria for 3 weeks last year. It was the most exhilarating experience I've ever had in my life. But I can see how, you know, banging on your drum. If you just want to bang on your drum all day, you should just bang on your drum all day, to be honest with you. That's okay. I don't want to work. Just want to slap this concussive dome. Makes me feel... I'm not shitting on drummers, man. You have no idea how much... And this sounds like it's going to be... I'm not shitting on drummers, but I'm going to shit on drummers. No, but I understand the feel of being in the rhythm, man. Played so much expert drumming in rock band Tom Sawyer. Ticket, 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 ticket. It's really good. Get yourself in there. And I'm saying, maybe you could have a balanced life. Like, maybe, you know, you can say, I don't want to work. A lot of people say that. I don't want to work, but I'll do it to finance my hobbies. How about that? There's a tinted rock back there. A lot of people are like, I don't want to work, but I can't just bang on a drum all day. Shut up, Mom. I can do whatever I want. You just do what everybody else does, I guess, and start a YouTube channel. You could be Bangs on His Drum at youtube.com/PewDiePie. Good. I appreciate those spirit hearts because apparently I can't be trusted with the HP that we have. I am very much excited about this Emperor card, to be honest with you. It's a great card. How is it possible that I'm not killing these guys a little bit faster? I'm not mad about it. Like, our run is still super high damage here. I'm just a little surprised, I would say. I could go to this curse room. I'm going to go to the cursor because we have 9 lives. I think I can afford to, even if it hurts me. Yeah, okay. I'm very glad that I did that. We'll also get a free deal with the devil, so not only are we guppy now, but we can reroll this. And we get the mark instead, which means we actually only paid 1 spirit heart to get in here. We got a damage upgrade and became guppy out of it. The knife might not create flies. That's okay. They created some of the dopest dance tracks of the mid-2000s, so, you know, they're entitled to take a break as far as I'm concerned. We'll just keep moving along here. This floor is a big one for deals with the devil, but really at this point, any deal that we get is just gravy. I would gladly kill myself to pick up a higher damage deal. I would gladly... We're not basically killing ourselves, we're only giving up 1 spirit heart. I would give up 1 spirit heart for a lot of items. A lot of items that are not necessarily that great. By most people's standards, at least. And I think there's pretty much no risk of us losing this run. 9 lives is just... It's so good. I can't get over the fact that there's people out there who don't like it. I understand the negativity associated with it. You know, oh, you lose a lot of HP in the process. Doesn't matter, man. There are the situations in which 9 lives is good vastly outnumber the situations in which 9 lives is bad. I like having an extra orbital. Yeah, absolutely, we'll pick up Gimpy. So we gotta think about the right way to do this. Because if I do this, if I pick it up right now, I die, but I respawn outside of the room and won't get the hearts. If I pick up both of these, I won't die, and I'll have 1 black heart remaining. Or maybe we'll have 1 blue heart. I think, yeah, it's 1 black heart. So I think that was the best way we could have done it, but it doesn't look that good. The best way would be if we had Goathead, we would take it, die, and then come back in and get to 3 black hearts because, well, 1 blue heart, 3 black hearts. Wait a minute, no, we're Isaac, so we won't respawn with a blue heart. We'll respawn with red hearts. Okay, so we should actually, like, I mean, this is fundamental stuff right here, but we should probably try not to die because if we die, we'll lose our Whore of Babylon damage. That would suck. I would rather not do that because we'd get a full red heart. And if you're Eve, a full red heart is adequate to put you in Whore of Babylon state. But if you're not Eve, you need to be at a half heart. The good news is, it's, you know, I'm not saying it's going to be impossible to kill us, but it should be easy for us to go a long time without dying. I was hoping there was like an actual judgment in there. Try that on for size. A little bit more money. There's a special room over here as a boss trap room. Red chest? I'll open it. Could be an item. Is not an item. Is a strength card. Don't love that as much because, again, the strength card, strangely enough, is kind of a damage downgrade for us. We lose Whore of Babylon state as a result of taking it. We got into it like a tricky situation here, which I like. I love how I looked for that judgment. And then when I didn't get a judgment, I was like, okay, we don't want the arcade. And then I found a cash judgment right here and was just like, no. We may end up having to take the magnet. Oh, you know what? We can skirt around this room a little bit. I was hoping that we'd be able to just, like, reroll it. We even get some extra combat here, which is nice. I really don't want to take the magnet, but it is nice to know that we don't have to pay for the, or we don't have to take the HP upgrade either. And we even got some extra HP back right here. Everything's coming up roses right now. This was already open because we were fighting a boss. That's me being a ding-dong. It's all right. It happens from time to time. I do dabble in ding-dong-ish. We need a couple more. Oh, no. We don't need a couple more rooms because we have a battery. But we might still be able to get 2 rerolls out of this if we play our cards right. Although we are going to use the Emperor card immediately after our boss fight. So hopefully we just reroll it once and then we're, you know, all's forgiven. We have, like, Polycephalus or something, right? There he is. Let's do small room, if possible. I will go back for that. There's our second secret room. We'll access it. I hope it's not an eternal heart. It is an eternal heart. Well, if we get to a permanent red heart state, we might want to pick that up. But for now, that won't be necessary. And in fact, would actually be bad. So we want to come in through the secret room, because if I don't, I'll probably just end up picking up the magnet, which is pretty much worthless for us. We roll it into Mom's brassiere. Well, wasn't there a battery on one of these rooms? Yeah. I guess we'll go use it right away. We can actually come back up the normal way this time. Book of Revelations. A little too late, but, you know, through all of our canoodling there. We gave ourselves an extra spirit heart, I guess, which is actually pretty nice. The longer we can keep ourselves alive, here, the better. Boss room's probably going to be close, so if we get another reroll, we may choose not to use it, just because we're going to fight Isaac as soon as we leave this floor anyway. We might as well minimize our chance, or minimize the number of rooms we have to go through on the chest to get a reroll. Although our reroll might not be necessary in the chest if we just get good items, but come on. You always want to reroll something, just to say you did it. Wow, that was the worst Spoonbender of all time. It's alright, Spoonbender, it's not your fault. I aimed you strangely, I suppose. Guppy definitely does work with Mom's knife here, and this run is going to be over very, very soon. Very, very nice start to our new streak here. We're 26 minutes in. It's a little slow, but it's not like it really matters in the whole scheme of things. It's been a comfortable run for quite some time. You stand basically no chance. Even like the two flies that we have right now, I was going to say, might be enough to finish the job. So we're down to the next floor, and the chest worries me a little bit, but as long as we can get to the boss, there's no concern. Yeah? Okay, we'll take Ipecac. It doesn't actually give us explosive shots, but it might give us a damage upgrade. I'm not totally sure. Wow, we should just use it as melee here. Just genuinely not totally sure. We can't take Thunder Thighs because we don't want HP. What we could do if we wanted to, like, super min-max it is, yeah, might as well take this. Is we could leave it there in case we died so we could get more HP, but where's the fun in that? Piggy bank, not worth it. Parasite doesn't work with Mom's knife as far as I know. I'll take Big Fan, and then we'll leave everything else for yet another reroll. Big Fan is a good item. I think at this point it's a little cliche, but I'm a big fan of it. I like the dollar bill. Shit is so cash. Anyway, you get the idea. Now we're just going to basically be farming up rerolls until we can find our boss, but I don't see much of a threat of us losing on that one. Infestation is not good, but the odds of us being able to reroll a single item pedestal are pretty low. We have a double item pedestal already. I'm assuming that we're going to find the boss, you know, relatively soon if we keep sticking to the terminals here. Tom Hanks. We don't get anything there. I love when you're doing so much damage to enemies. I've said this a lot before, but I love when you do so much damage to enemies that when you kill one, the other one actually seems to gain HP because it's like, whoa, you overkilled the shit out of that dude. We got to rebalance this other dude over here a little bit because you're going to get the wrong idea. I wish there was a way we could kill the Haunt in one hit. It almost actually happened there, strangely enough. More keys. This is our last room over here, and it's also the last room before we get a reroll. No chests, but that's okay. This is a great Isaac run. There is almost nothing that I can offer as like a negative for what is happening on this run. I'm very pleased with it. I had to think about it, because this does ruin Whore of Babylon, but on the other hand, it gives us 1.5 times damage. Does Whore of Babylon give us 1.5 times damage? It might. I don't know. But I figured, you know, Magic Mush, I know it's so good, we might as well take it. It might be kind of a lateral move. Whatever, though. At least it is a monstrous fucking tooth, right? Anything special over here? Just a dude end. More bombs than I can shake a stick at. Double adversary room is the only real test we've had on this floor so far, which is exciting. And it's over. We passed. Probably got like a B plus there. You know, we've done better, but still real good. And let's just go fight our boss. You know what? We'll go back and reroll Monstro's Tooth because I'm a man of the people. Let's go back here. We got Notched Axe instead. That's why I'm not going to be a man of the people much longer. Because of bullshit like that. Are you happy, Isaac? You're breaking my faith in the human race. You big disgrace. Waving your feather all over the place. What is it, like a bird or something? Or is it like a quill? You know, they're having like a poetry contest. We will rock you. Anyway, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the episode. If you did, click the like button. It helps out a great deal. And of course, subscribe if you want to see more in the future. But for now, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.